One of the greatest things about being here at the Waldorf Astoria is over the past couple of days, we, Bill, have gotten to go to all the theme parks. And yesterday, we spent the day at SeaWorld.
And it was awesome.
Yeah,
we got behind-the-scenes tours. We had dinner with Shamu.
Yeah, he even splashed us.
But you guys got treated better than I do.
That's Corey Oxman. She's one of the animal trainers at SeaWorld. And she brought Henry by. Now, Henry looks like a little mini owl.
He looks like a mini owl. He's actually full grown. Oh, I don't know if you can hear that. He's vocalizing now.
Yeah, he's making noises. He doesn't like us. Sorry.
Henry's only about 120 grams, about the size of my hand. And he is full grown. He's 3 years old. Henry is one of our rescued animals. He fell out of a tree, broke his jaw, and when the jaw healed, it didn't heal straight. So because of that, Henry wouldn't be able to survive on his own. His beak will continually grow, just like our fingernails. And if he doesn't have the proper alignment, it can grow over itself.
Oh, wow.
So in our care, we're able to file it down, keep an eye on it, and make sure that he's still able to open it and eat properly.
What does he eat?
Henry loves mice. Now in the wild,
he eats a mouse?
Can you believe it?
That little tiny thing?
He's about a fifth of his body weight every night.
Wow. Who gets to feed him the mice? That'd be fun.
We usually just set them in there and let him eat on his own so he can have his privacy.
I have so many questions. Are they live when Henry...
Yeah.
No.
Not like a snake.
No, we get our food frozen. We actually get it from a gourmet rodent company. And it's only the finest rodents that we feed Henry.
Wait a minute. There's such an oxymoron there. Are you kidding me?
It's like
gourmet...
Whole Foods mice or something.
Oh, my God.
Restaurant quality rodents.
Right. That is awesome, though. But, you know, people don't realize until you really get to see SeaWorld and you see it and look into what you do, how much research there is and how much rescue effort. You do an amazing job. We saw the whole behind the scenes where they're the tanks, too, and the manatee rescue.
Right. Yeah. Now, there's a small percentage of the animals that we have that cannot be returned to the wild due to their conditions. And so in that case, we're able to keep them at our parks or at another accredited facility. They receive long-term care.
Right.
Now, when there's like a manatee gets hurt or a whale gets, you know, runs ashore or a Henry falls out of a tree, is it from all over the state, all over the region that you guys respond?
We work with local, state, and federal agencies. So a lot of the times it'll be a local rescue. We've also gotten animals in all the way from the coast of Massachusetts in Cape Cod.
Wow.
There was a manatee that wound up there in Cape Cod. We named him Dennis because he was found around the coast of Dennis, Massachusetts. And so we were able to drive up there as soon as we got the call from the federal agencies. They called us up there. We drove, we rescued Dennis and brought him all the way back to Florida, rehabilitated him at SeaWorld.
How does one transport a manatee?
In a very large vehicle. We have a refrigerated truck and there's water in there and we have a veterinarian to make sure that his vitals are stable. And we take care of him on the entire transport down.
That's amazing.
You do great work.
Yeah,
you do.
Really
Thank
do.
You. We love what we do.
All right. We're going to trade off Henry for this ball of a thing that's
so
next
this
to you.
So this ball of a thing that you're looking at right here is Bocce.
Bocce
ball.
That's perfect.
It's an Italian animal. Okay.
He's actually Brazilian. Three banded armadillos are found in Brazil. Now, here in the United States, we have the nine banded armadillo, which is about three times the size of this little guy. The three-banded armadillo is the only kind that will actually roll up into a tight ball like you see him right now. Everything has its place. It's kind of like a jigsaw
Look
puzzle.
At that.
It's like he's locked.
Now, that's a great defense mechanism. If a predator were to come and try to get him, he curls up into that ball and protects his insides because the predator cannot get through that bony plated
it's
shell.
Amazing.
That is awesome.
It's a great adaptation that they have.
It's a great name for him, too. Now, how did you come to...
Bocce was actually born at our sister park, Busch Gardens in Tampa.
Okay.
So he's been part of our family. He's only a few months old. He's still very young. And he's one of our animal ambassadors that makes appearances at the Sea Garden at SeaWorld Orlando.
Now, what does Bocce eat?
Bocce eats lots of insects. We also give him some fruits and vegetables. But his favorite are mealworms.
Oh, boy, they get great diets.
Boy, mice, mealworms,
gourmet, restaurant quality mealworms.
Right, of course. Only the best.
Yeah,
organic.
Right next to those mice. He's way cool, though. Now, would he bite? Does he bite? What is the purpose of an armadillo?
Oh, they make burrows and grounds. They're great for rooting up the ground and turning over soil. And they also eat a lot of insects.
Yeah.
So, I mean, no one really wants a ton of insects around your house, right? So we have all these animals. The owl, too, they'll eat insects. So we keep all these other animals around to control the entire ecosystem. Otherwise, if one animal is gone, then the other populations of animals will, you know, get out of balance.
Can one buy a bocce somewhere and keep it for a pet?
I highly discourage buying exotic animals, especially when you don't know where they're coming from.
Right.
Unfortunately, armadillos are very vulnerable to the illegal pet trade. People are smuggling them in and selling them as pets. So when you are looking for a pet, do your research. I'd recommend sticking to your typical dogs, cats, birds, and hamsters. But, these animals are smuggled in and sold as pets, unfortunately.
Most. Really? For what purpose?
People love to have cool things in their house. You know, you see some people have monkeys or armadillos or, you know, it's fun to show off. But unless you do your research, these animals take a lot of specialized care. And so we don't recommend having them as pets.
Yeah, I don't mean to get off the beaten path here. But on that note, hedgehogs all of a sudden are like the cool animal to have.
Are they?
Oh, yeah.
They are cool animals. Again, I don't recommend them as pets unless you've done your research and you know a lot about them and how to care for them.
They live in the ground and they make holes and that's what they're supposed to do.
Right, so you have to have the right habitat for them and, you know, maybe a big yard. But a lot of people just think it's a cool animal to have and they put it in, you know,
a fish tank
or a cage. Yeah. And then they start getting very destructive. And what happens then is people say, my pet's being destructive. What do I do with it? I'm just going to turn it out into the wild. Well, now these animals are becoming invasive species. It's happening a lot with reptiles, with iguanas and chameleons down in the Everglades. They're turning up everywhere.
Pythons. See that problem all the time?
Yeah, they're not native to the United States, but when people don't know how to care for their pets, that's, to them, the best alternative, which it's not. You know, you need to find a better home for a pet.
Well, we do have better homes for the exotic. It's SeaWorld and Busch Gardens, your sister park.
Yes.
That's why we come visit you
and
all the great
work
you do.
And we do host pet amnesty days. So if somebody has a pet that they can't care for, we have these amnesty days where you can come, surrender your pet, no questions asked, and we'll make sure we find a responsible home for it.
It's just cool. Awesome.
Right.
Well, we love Henry. We love Bocce. I'm going to go kid. No one plays Bocce ball with him, right?
No, but he does. He's about checking. The size of a Bocce ball.
Right? It's perfect.
Just checking. Does he roll? I mean, like, could you roll him? Does he stay like
no,
that?
No, we're not going to roll him.
I'm not asking you to do that, but I mean, like, does he roll when he's like that?
No, he'll just curl up and hang out in that tight ball until, if there's a threat around, he'll hang out in that tight ball until the threat's gone, and then he'll go running. It's like he's on little high heels. He click-clacks, and it looks like he's on tiny little armadillo high heels.
So cool.
Long nails that they use for digging. You can see here, Rhonda's going to pull
him. Oh, he's hairy.
Table. Yeah, they're mammals, so they do have hair, mostly on the underbelly there.
Can I touch him?
You can touch him on his back. Now, armadillos have an amazing sense of smell, and with those big ears, you can tell they have a great sense of hearing
warm.
As well.
Is he warm because you were holding him? Or is that his natural? Oh, he likes my glasses.
He's probably sniffing he's sniffing your glass of water. They'll probably take a few licks. Now, they have these long, sticky tongue. They're related to anteaters and sloths. So they have this long, sticky tongue that comes out to pull the insects in or whatever he's eating or drinking.
Does he want some water?
We'll probably keep him away from the human food and water.
Okay, all right. Just thought I'd ask. Well, Corey, thank you so very much. Thank you to SeaWorld for being our host. We had a ball while we were there. And Henry and Bocce, you can come visit us anytime.
Anytime.
Well, come visit us at SeaWorld. And, you know, for the best ticket deals and offers, SeaWorldOrlando.com is the website to go to for hours and park information.
That's great. Perfect.
Thanks.
Thank you. Great
Thanks
job.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks for what you do.